And for the cast, did you draw on the 1939 film as well, or did you, like James, dig into the books as well? Zach, let's start with you.
I had never read the books, so I don't know. It's tricky for me to answer because I you know, I'm creating this new character, whereas I'm maybe the witches could answer because there's something to look to. So I mean, I guess if anything, I saw the monkey as being, you know, the comic relief in a way that that the animals, the lion and the scarecrow and the tin man were. So it was sort of the physical comedy of it all. I think there was a couple of subtle places where Sam and I found to put in some fun physical comedy that was an homage to those three characters.
Michelle?
Well, Sam and I had a conversation at the when we were in rehearsals, because I wanted to know if I was going to talk in a funny voice and wear like a big pink dress. And Sam was very, made a really great point, which was that Glinda in the original movie, there's a reason that she doesn't go on the yellow brick road with Dorothy and her friends. It's because she doesn't need anything. And that makes her a little bit one-dimensional, and he wanted to bring out her more human qualities. So the original film was an inspiration, has always been an inspiration, but it wasn't really like my jumping off point. The books were valuable to me.
Okay, and Rachel and Mila, the same question. Did you draw upon the films or the books or both?
My character Evanora is not in the books, right?
Right.
Yeah. So I couldn't draw inspiration mm-hmm. from the book. She's a made-up character by the screenplay writer and by Sam and by
screenplay writer. Yeah. Dave Bear and Mitchell Kapner.
They made her up. So so it was just I guess in the 1939 film. Her feet sticking out from under the house. So
did you take inspiration from her feet?
Zach, I did. I did. Those ruby slippers.
I noticed. If anyone else didn't notice, I noticed.
I internalized the slippers and changed them into black leather lace-up boots because that's more Evanora's speed.
And Amila?
The truth is no, I didn't, because I didn't want to emulate or imitate or do anything that would take away from the iconic character that was so created wonderfully and beautifully and will always remain so iconic. What I was given was a gift of a backstory. And so given the origin of the character and humanizing her in a way and rooting her, I mean, she's very simple. If you look at it, it's just a girl who gets her heart broken, who doesn't know how to deal with pain, takes the easy way out, numbs the pain, and has an emotional transformation that just so happens to be mirrored with a physical one. Mm. And the second that she became human to me is when it made sense. Everything else was kind of very secondary. She's, you know, a woman scorned who just so happens to know how to fly. and that's the truth. I would never dare try to emulate something that's so beyond iconic.